Lord, to those who fear him. And for he himself, by the humble form, recovers what all made of dust. Amen. His days resemble to grass, as if all continues so shall be blue. But that it was past all rain, and his God and evermore shall moisten place again. But the love of the Lord is from all eternity to all eternity for those who fear him. And just as upon the children of children of those who keep his covenant and remember his laws to obey them. The Lord is established strong in heaven, for all things his kingship is supreme. Bless the Lord, his angels, your strong and mighty ones, who obey his word on you and the Son of his decree. Bless the Lord, his power is dependent to obey his will. Bless the Lord, his words in every place of his dominion. Bless the Lord, my soul. Bless the Lord, my soul in every place of his dominion. O Lord, hear my prayer and choose to heed to my being and righteous answer. And enter not into judgment with him.
With your servant.
Since all the living man is just at your side, the enemy is not to be down, his first my life into the ground. His force will deliver the darkness of those on bed. My spirit fails to grief and within my heart is in despair. I recall the days of old and meditate on all your deeds as upon the works of your hand. I stretch out my hand to you like a parched hand, my soul thirsts for you. Make haste and answer me, Lord. My spirit is stabbing. Turn not your face away from me, lest I be like those in the pit. Grant that I may hear you steadfast and love and dawn, for I bless my own in you. O Lord, teach me the way I should go, for I lift up my soul to you. O Lord, deliver me from my enemies. It is you that I have led. Teach me to do your will, for you, O my God. May you, good spirits, lead me in a straight path for the sake of your name, O Lord, who will keep me alive. In your righteousness, you deliver me from affliction, and your love and kindness will destroy my enemies, and bring to all those who oppose me, for I am your servant. O Lord, hear my prayer, and truth will be heed to my pain, and righteous answer me. May you, good spirits, lead me in a straight path. Those who have been gay, okay, you're bad, and you can't be gay, and you can't be gay, amen. Alleluia, 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 voces sobre vos. Alleluia, 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 voces sobre vos. Alleluia, 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 voces sobre vos.
Oh, Oh.
James, the brother of the Lord. On this day, we also commemorate the devoted father. Canisius, Patrick of Casa Noble. On this day, we also commemorate our devoted father, Macarios Belovin. Our devoted father, Nikiforos, the founder of the monastery of Chersianos, died in peace by the holy intercession of God. Have mercy on us. Amen. I hope. Lord, give it to the poor. Oh, Lord, show my best and my mother.
Thank you. Thank you.
extremely zealous was I in the condition of my fathers. But when he who had set me apart before I was born, and had called me through his grace, was pleased to reveal his Son to me, in order that I might preach him among the Gentiles, I did not confer with flesh and blood, nor did I go up to Jerusalem to those who were apostles before me. But I went away into Arabia, and again I returned to Damascus. Then after 3 years, I went up to Jerusalem to visit Cephas, and remained within 15 days. But I saw none of the other apostles, except James, the Lord's brother.
Και όρμησεν οι αγέλη κάτω του κρίνου εις τη μύρη. They worship God. They know their Creator and they worship Him. They serve God. Angels are obedient ministers to His will. One of their chief services is to assist us. They bring peace and take away our fear at the Lord's will. All of us were assigned a guardian angel at our baptism. Every church has an angel assigned to it that protects it. In the beginning, there were 10 ranks of angels. Dominions, thrones, principalities, angels, archangels, etc. And there are many angels in each rank. The angels, just like us humans, have a free will. The freedom to love or reject their Creator. They were all given a pivotal moment of choice millennia before we in the physical world even existed. Those angels which chose to follow the angel called Lucifer, Eosphoros, are what we call demons. In one moment, God's beloved angel Lucifer desired the throne of God. It is in this moment, as Jesus pointed out in Luke chapter 10, that I saw Satan fall from heaven like lightning. The angels that fell from heaven that day are called demons. One entire rank of angels fell that day. Until Archangel made the call that we will hear in the Divine Liturgy, let us stand aright, let us stand in awe. Stomen kalos, stomen metaphobos. In that moment, the fate of both angels and demons were sealed. Angels will forever serve the Lord in the eternal kingdom of heaven. Demons also await eternity, but in hell. And as Jesus said, hell was created for the devil and his demons. Then, once physical history began, God created Adam and Eve. And the energies of the devil and his angels turned toward destroying this beloved creation of God. The serpent in the garden didn't use many lies to convince Eve to eat the fruit. He actually told many truths with one little lie. That you will become like God, which is the same sin he had committed and mastered. And here lies a big distinction between angels and demons. Angels tell the truth, always. But the devil tells us many truths with one or few little lies mixed in. And both of these have similar qualities in that they don't take on bodily form, except on rare occasion. They have a vast knowledge since they have existed for many millennia. They are not omnipresent. However, they can travel very fast from one point to another. And they have the knowledge of present time. For us baptized Orthodox Christians, we have been sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. If we are active participants in the sacramental, spiritual life, the devil cannot touch us. We must always be vigilant and bring any evil spiritual visions to the church. Prayer is very important. Even the Virgin Mary had fear and examined the vision of Archangel Gabriel. And in humility, she told no one. If anyone has seen a holy vision, and the next day you're talking about it with your friends over coffee, it's probably not a holy vision. The Lord usually appears to those who are very holy and quiet people, humble. Jesus Christ expels demons immediately. That is why it is important to come to the church to receive Holy Communion, Holy Confession. Jesus has given authority for the clergy to cast out evil demons. must bring our books, visions, sicknesses, tribulations, everything to the church. Jesus Christ and the Holy Trinity work through the church, through the Holy Priesthood. We see this in today's Gospel that Jesus vanquished the demons immediately. They cry for mercy. At the power of God, all evil trembles and has no chance. We sit here today listening to these messages. The Gadarenes actually saw the miracle, but unfortunately paid attention to their own businesses, which Jesus was affecting. The demons possessed the pigs, and the pigs jumped off a cliff. The Gadarenes had also lost their way and did not practice the worship in the one true God. That is why they were farming pigs to begin with. We too have seen countless miracles, read many accounts of the awesome power of the Lord. We have been given so much. Will we glorify our Lord as the angels do? Will we serve Him? Will we use our free will to turn to Him and turn our families to Him so that He can bless us? When we grow distant from God, we end up losing our way and join the ways of the world. Will we ask Him to leave us as the Gadarenes did today? Anytime we prioritize something ahead of God, we do this. Will our Lord recognize our faces in the next life because He recognizes us in this life? Is our spiritual strength like that of the angels? If not, then we have a lot of work to do. It is in our hands. The visible and invisible forces at war have no choice at defeating the light of Christ. No chance at defeating the light of Christ. It is up to us to be His body and to be on His side eternally. You might have heard of a battle between good and evil. This is a myth. This yin-yang dichotomy does not exist for us Christians. When the Lord is present and we let His light in, there is no battle between good and evil. Jesus Christ is victorious. Always. Jesus Christos Nikar. We just need to be on His side, not on the side of greed, pride, envy. All these things make up unholiness. We must be like angels, constantly praising and serving God, and the protection of His wings will shelter us and overshadow us. Amen.
I believe in one God, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven begotten, not created, of one essence with the Father, through whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven and was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary and became man. He was crucified for us under Pontius Pilate and suffered and was buried. And he rose on the third day according to the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. And he will come again with glory to judge the living and the dead. His kingdom shall have no end. And in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the Creator of life, who proceeds from the Father, who together with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who spoke through the prophets, in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church, I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the age to come. Amen.
Thank you.
soul and body, and the pledge of the future life and kingdom. is good for me to cling to God and to place in Him the hope of my salvation. Receive me today, Son of God, as a partaker of your mystical suffering. I will not reveal your mysteries to your adversaries, nor will I give to you a kiss as the Jews. But as a thief, I confess it. Lord, remember me.
Thank you.
I would like to say just a few words in Greek for my good friend Petros, να ακούσεις και μια ελληνική λέξη σήμερα. And for those who appreciate hearing a few words in Greek. Σήμερα θέλουμε την έκδοση.
Χριστός βγάζει τα δαιμόνια από ένα κύριο. Και αυτό είναι μεγάλο θαύμα, αλλά για μας τι σημαίνει αυτό? Πως υπάρχει ο αόρατος και ο ορατός κόσμος. Και ο Χριστός πριν φτιάξει τον ορατό κόσμο που ζούμε, έφτιαξε τον αόρατο κόσμο. Δηλαδή, η Βασιλεία των Ουρανών και το γέμισε με αγγέλους. Οι άγγελοι είναι όντως αληθινά όντα, πλάσματα και υπήρξε κάποτε μία αποφασιστική στιγμή που οι άγγελοι έπρεπε να διαλέξουν τον δρόμο του Θεού ή να πέσουν στη γη. Και ο Εωσφόρος που ήταν λαμπρός άγγελος του Κυρίου επέλεξε να πέσει στη γη. Ήθελε το θρόνο του Θεού και είχε αυτή την αμαρτία του εγωισμού του που θέλει αυτός να είναι στο θρόνο του Θεού. Και πέσανε πολλοί άγγελοι μέχρι ο Αρχάγγελος Μιχαήλ φώναξε το στόμεν, καλό στόμεν με τα φόβου. Πρόσκομε την Αγία Αναφορά και όπως λέμε στη Θεία Λειτουργία. Και για μας αυτό σημαίνει πως υπάρχουν οι άγγελοι που μας αγαπούν και τηρούν το θέλημα του Θεού, αλλά υπάρχουν και οι δαίμονες που θέλουν την πτώση μας, την πνευματική αλλά και την σωματική πτώση. Για μας τι σημαίνει αυτό επιπλέον? Σημαίνει πως πρέπει να προσέχουμε. Πρέπει να έχουμε μία ζωή μυστηριακή, κοινωνική με το Θεό μας. Πρέπει να καταλαμβάνουμε τα Θεία Δώρα, το Σώμα και το Αίμα του Κυρίου. Πρέπει και όλα τα μυστήρια της Εκκλησίας, της Θείας Εξομολογήσεως, το Θείο Ευχέλαιο κτλ. Πρέπει να συμμετάσχουμε, διότι όλα αυτά, ξεκινώντας με το βάπτισμά μας και το χρίσμα μας, μας προστατεύουν από όλες τις δυνάμεις του διαβόλου. Πέρα από αυτό, για την αγάπη του Θεού πρέπει πάνω απ' όλα να πλησιάζουμε τα μυστήρια. Και θα καταλήξω με με αυτό το τελικό. Πολλοί από εμάς ασχολούμαστε πάρα πολύ με το φόβο του διαβόλου. Και εγώ τώρα αυτά που σας είπα είναι περί αγγέλων, διαβόλων, αλλά πρέπει να τα βάζουμε στη σειρά. Πρέπει να έχουμε αγάπη του Θεού και με την αγάπη του Θεού και το φως του Χριστού δεν γίνεται να μας πιάσει ο διάβολος. Αλλά υπάρχουν οι περιπτώσεις που υπάρχουν η αρρώστια της ψυχής. Υπάρχει η βασκανία, το μάτι που λέμε. Και πρέπει σε αυτές τις στιγμές να έρχεται ο καθένας στην εκκλησία και ο ιερέας να διαβάσει την ανάλογη ευχή. Ο ιερέας βέβαια δεν είναι ακριβώς σαν γιατρός ή σαν χειρουργός που ξέρει άμα είναι βασκανία ή όχι, αλλά θα διαβάσει αυτή την ευχή και ο Θεός θα ευλογήσει τον άνθρωπο. Και ευχόμαστε να διατρεφτεί η ψυχή. Αλλά το φάρμακο, το πρώτο απ' όλα, είναι η Θεία Κοινωνία και η Θεία Εξομολόγηση. Αυτά τακτοποιούν τα πάντα και το μάτι και όλες τις άλλες αρρώστιες. Οπότε, άμα ξέρετε κάποιον που ματιάζει, να τους δώσετε μήνυμα πως που ξεματιάζει κάποιον, δεν πρέπει αυτοί να ξεματιάζουν. Ο ιερέας μόνο πρέπει να ξεματιάζει. Και να ξέρετε ότι ό,τι είναι από το Θεό είναι φανερό, δεν είναι μυστικό. Οπότε πολλές ευχές αυτές που κυκλοφορούν μεταξύ των λαϊκών είναι μυστικά, είναι ο ένας από τον άλλον, η μία στην άλλη. Πρέπει να είναι η σημερία, αυτή την ημέρα, 28 Οκτωβρίου, ξέρω εγώ. Τέλος πάντων, αυτά τα μυστικά πράγματα είναι του διαβόλου και πρέπει πολύ μακριά. Και άμα ξέρετε κάποιον, να τους δώσετε ειδικό μήνυμα από τον Χριστό που έστειλε εμένα να σας δώσω αυτό το μήνυμα και να έρθουν σε μένα.
να μας επισκιάσει όλους και να μας προστατεύει πάντοτε και να είμαστε στα χέρια των Αγγέλων σε αυτή τη ζωή και ελπίζουμε και στην επόμενη ζωή. A few announcements for this week. We have Bible study and book club tomorrow. Paráclisis is at 5:30 and 6:30 here in the church. We will have our book club and Bible study. We are studying the Divine Liturgy. Whoever wishes to join us also at home on Zoom, you can speak to me and I will share with you the special Zoom link. We have the Liturgy of St. Demetrius. Is that on Wednesday?
Wednesday.
We have a Divine Liturgy for St. Demetrius. We also got our new icons. We have 20 new icons. If you haven't seen them in the side room, please take a look. It's a big blessing. St. Nectarios behind you, Mr. Khalil, is brand new as well, part of the new set. God has blessed St. George with many Byzantine icons, and we thank you for your donations and for the beauty that you have brought in here, and the liturgics of the church, along with you, along with the icons, along with our offerings, is what beautifies our church inside and out, and will reign for many, many years in the city of Schenectady. Thank you. So we will take out the icon of St. Demetrius. We will also have our Ecclesia on that day. I think that's it for services coming up. Any more announcements? Philotokos is having their meeting at 12:15 after coffee hour in the Hellenic Center. Any other announcements? General Assembly is November 6th. I think that's it. I'd like to welcome everyone, but especially my good friend from Greece, Petros Anagnostou. Mr. Petros has been a friend for many years. He has a store in Athens with beautiful carved wood and all different sorts of church supplies. He's been a friend for many years. I know him from Resurrection, but he's also a very good friend to Father Dionysios from Albany, who's now in Chicago. I don't know those of you who know him, his name was Stavro, they have been friends for many, many, many years. He loves to visit this area of state, and today it was a big honor to have you here, Pedro. We hope you can give us some advice on some of the church items needed. Some of the things I know need some doing, but maybe you could give me your advice. I know that the Gospels are, one of them is more new, but the other one definitely needs some repair. So maybe you could take that with you back to Greece and send us back a new one. Many of the needs that we have, we will be contacting you to give us a quote. So thank you. Thank you for being here with us. Make sure you get to meet everyone at coffee hour. I think that's it. Please